Strip it down, meat and potatoes. A lot of the songs kind of are sad, which makes sense because, like I'm always telling my therapist, people don't change. And sort of drill down to the core of a person. You do all this extra work, but I mean, ultimately, we really are who we are. So it's sad, but also consistent and really reliable. And it's why I still like a lot of the people that I used to like when I was just forming as a human being, like Tegan, for example. I can't break that habit. And then, but that's how we all feel about our first friend or our first roommate or our first partner or whatever. I mean, when you are selected to share a womb with somebody, it's hard to sort of turn your back on them because like how many other roommates are you gonna get? Jokes. It's on. That was a good one. Yeah. They don't really. It's a big space. Okay. You know what? Let it percolate and think about it later. So, anyways, the good news is that although the songs in the next section don't really necessarily relate to the same set of circumstances that influenced and inspired the con, because I haven't changed. Almost every other experience I've had, dealing with grief or dealing with heartbreak or loss, I pretty much write the same kinds of songs about the same kinds of experiences. And so it was easy for me to select some songs that I feel connect to the con. And Tegan just selected songs that she knows you guys would like, because she's a golden retriever, so she wants to... If you just want to sort of stare disappointedly and pensively at me when I play my songs, that's fine, because that's what I sort of long for, actually, in a sort of relationship. But Tegan, she needs a little bit of extra boost, you know? Like, good boy, good boy, good boy. So, I'm not talking down to her. She loves this. She didn't tell me this. Oh, no, I am nicer and I want to please you. That's true. She is. That's right. You know what? If we both were like that, it would be grotesque. You know, it's really, it's only because one of us is nice that the other one can be the bad cop. And every good duo, like, needs a bad cop, I think. Or just an asshole. But so... we hope that you enjoyed this little section. Oddly, these, even though we play half as many songs, it takes almost as much time as the whole con, because the con was so weirdly short in some places. So if you have to go to the bathroom, please feel free to go, or just wet yourself. I'm going to wet myself probably a couple of songs from now, so really high point of the tour.
The show
feels long sometimes. We've been playing like hour 15 minutes as the other day. We actually all had to leave the stage to go to the bathroom.
Not all of us. Not this guy.
That's true. This is the difference also in touring an album in your late 30s, is your bladder is just, it's just different, you know? Anyways, here we go. Here's the song. Glad you're still here.